Hello friends, welcome to the channel Trading Strategies. Today is 13th June 2020. We'll see how the Nifty, Bank Nifty for next week, how to trade weekly levels for the next week, that is 15th June to 19th June. This week, what are the levels to be watched and the trading idea for 15th June, that is Monday, how we have to trade Nifty, Bank Nifty, and total week, how Nifty and Bank Nifty levels, where we may get high resistance and good support areas, we will see now. Straight away, we'll go to the technical chart. See, this is the Nifty technical chart. This is a Nifty weekly chart. If you see last week, this is the candle, this week candle. So, comparatively, previous week, this week high is high. And this gap, the weekly gap, this gap is filled in this week. The previous gap area, that is 9700 to 9600. I am explaining this gap area from several days. This is the important support for the market. So that support took yesterday, that is Friday, and went up. In the last week also, we discussed about the 10,270 level. That is the key resistance. Only if closed above that, then there could be a decent rally. But it has not crossed that level in this week also, 10,270 kind of levels. So, 10,000, the weekly basis, it is not closed above that. So, there could, it is not decent rally we have seen in this week. So, how to trade next week? What are the levels to be watched? See, if you see the this is the weekly rally and drop and rally, and this rally will have certain levels, we'll see now. So from here and fall and drop, see 10,276 is the key resistance going forward. Now also, if the price closed, Nifty closed above 10,328, that is 330, we can say 10,330, then we can expect the rally will continue till this gap, 10,700. So, we will see in between any levels are there to some resistance for the rally. On the lower side, this week also, important level is this 9,600. If the price closed below 9,600, then there could be a deep correction in the market and the market may fall to the level, this level, 8,800. So, 9,600, 8,800. 800 points downside we can expect if the price closed below 9,590 on a closing basis. If the price closed above this candle high, that is 10,325, then we can expect the rally will continue up to 10,750, 10,800. So, these are the levels to be watched for the coming week. We'll see any resistance areas in between these two, 10,270 and 10,750, and also the downside, any support is there in a minor supports. These are the major levels to be noted, and we'll see on a daily chart. So this is a Friday candle. Market opened very deep red and closed in green. So this level has given a decent support. This gap already filled. So there is only one gap, is 10,700 and 10,800. And if you see the Fibonacci extension also, this is the weekly levels. Now we'll see a daily also. So this is the drop, and if you see the entire rally, what is the retracement? This is the entire fall from 12,150 to 7,500. So the remove this. This is the fall from 12,100 to 7,500 and the retracement. The retracement tested almost 61.8% here, and from there it is dropping, and it is not closed below 38.2%. So there could be a high probability of going upside only. So as we see, this level 10,379 and 10,300 kind of levels, there might be a small resistance area in this area, this high. Once this cross, then the rally will continue up to 10,700 and 10,800 levels. So this levels to be noted very carefully. If you are an option trader, you can trade on a long side with hedging, or you can go with a long call spread. So buying around 10,200 call and selling at 10,500 call. So or 10,300 call you can buy and sell 10,500 call, so that the risk is limited, so you'll get decent profits. That way you can trade in options. Now we'll see the Bank Nifty also. Yeah, before going to Bank Nifty, we'll see the Nifty, how we have to trade on Monday. The intraday Monday levels, how we have to trade. Any dip in the market on Monday, that can be bought. So where we have to buy is very important. So 9,972 is the closing price, and previous day close 9,902, 70 points down, and the 50% retracement is 9,830. So this is the area we can enter as a long, keeping a stop loss of only 50 points. So this is the area. Yeah, see, this is the Friday price action. This is the Friday price action. So it opened here and went into the zone and crossed the zone and rally. So this area will give you a decent support on Monday. So this is the entry around 9,825, 830, and keep a stop loss of 50 points only. And aim for a target of today's previous day high. So 9,950, 960 kind of levels where you can take your profits. Well, so this way you can plan for Monday trade Nifty. Now we'll see the Bank Nifty for weekly and also the trade for Monday. This is the Bank Nifty weekly chart. If you see the weekly levels, so previous weekly supply honored this week. it went almost 21,800, and the zone is 21,530 and 21,961 is the supply for the week ended. So the high of this week closed yesterday is 21,800. From there it went all the way down 19,500, that is the lowest, and closed 20,654. So the key retracement level, this 20,700, is honored, almost it is near to that. So this week, if the price closed above 21,900 on a daily closing basis, there could be a testing of this level, 22,900, 1000 points from here. Otherwise, if the market doesn't move anywhere, it may a range bound trade in between 21,900 and this low. This low is 19,600. So 21,900 and 19,600 are the key levels to watch out. For either side, if any side it breaks on a daily closing basis, there could be another 1,000-2,000 points of rally or downside. If the downside breaks, it may fall up to 17,300. If upside breakout, it may go up to 23,000. That is the levels for weekly. But we will see the on a daily basis. This is a daily chart,
right?
So in between also not much difference, because this gap is closed on Friday. So this is the support. This I explained several times, where Bank Nifty will take good support. So last week almost every day I explained about this gap. If the price comes to this gap area, it has give a decent bounce. So that happened on Friday. So now also this area will give you a decent support. Only if the price closed above 19,300 on a daily closing basis, there could be a deep fall and it may go all the way to 17,300 levels. On the upside, it should close above 21,900, then only it may move further upside. Until then, it could be a consolidation in between 19,500 to 21,600 kind of levels. So how to trade on Monday, exclusively only for intraday trading on Monday, we'll see. This is the 15 minute chart. See, this gap area has taken on Friday good support and rallied, decent rally. And if you see the price action, rally, base, rally, small drop, again rally. So this drop break area will give you a decent support on Monday. That is 20,250 kind of levels give you a decent support. If the price comes this area, we can attempt to buy and keep a stop loss of 100 points. Aim for a target of 20,600 on Monday. If Monday any gap up opens, that gap up will may be filled on the day and then the rally will continue. So we have to watch out any gap. In the gap down, no problem, that will give you a decent support. If the gap up opens, that means if opened above 20,750 or 770 and wait for at least 15 minutes or half an hour to see how the gap filling or not filling. If the gap doesn't fill and continues to rally, that rally may continue. So friend, that's it for the today. For the next week, for Nifty and Bank Nifty levels and how to trade on Monday. So I'll come up with one more video for stocks to trade on Monday. Thank you for watching this video. If you're not subscribed, please subscribe.